Today in the news, we got AMD, Nvidia, and Intel, the holy trinity of GPUs. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. With the RTX Super line of GPUs on the horizon, Navi has got some tough competition ahead, especially given the fact that the RTX line has ray tracing hardware built in, which could definitely sway the decision for the consumer. Now, we've heard that AMD has been working on a ray tracing solution for their RDNA architecture, but we didn't really get much more information. All we know is that the potential big Navi or Navi 21 chips and the Xbox Scarlet and PS5 are supposed to support it. Well, over the weekend on Reddit, a user by the name of Noiserr found an AMD patent for ray tracing. On this patent, it looks like AMD is taking more of a hybrid approach to ray tracing. With Nvidia's design, the ray tracing cores do just that, ray tracing. And while the Tensor cores are there to support ray tracing with the use of DLSS, they could also be used for ray tracing as shown by the Titan V. But of course, that's not what Nvidia uses them for. Anyways, going back to AMD's patent, it looks like their version of ray tracing is more of a hybrid approach. Basically, if you use software for ray tracing on hardware that wasn't really optimized for it, well, you drop a lot of performance, just like we saw with the GTX 1080 Ti when Nvidia enabled ray tracing for it. But AMD doesn't think that reserving large die areas for ray tracing is a solution either. So by using a mix of dedicated ray tracing hardware and sort of cramming it into the shader units pipeline and then using software to optimize it, you should be able to keep the hardware ray tracing capabilities but not sacrifice too much on die area. Okay, hold up. This is Editing Snows, and I just wanted to add something here because this is really complicated. Nvidia sends the data from the shaders to the RT cores, and once a ray hits, then it gets back to the shaders for shading. What AMD shows here is to send the data from the shaders to a texture processing unit, which will then return the info to the shaders. Basically, the TPUs will be able to do the job of the RT cores and regular TPU operations, or at least that's what I get from the patent. Hopefully, this makes it a little bit clearer, but once again, really complicated. Back to me. Now, this patent was filed back in December of 2017 and just got published a few days ago. So is this patent related to Big Navi? I mean, it's possible, but I think that this is probably what has been developed for consoles. Consoles need to save as much space as possible on the die since they don't have the luxury of having separate CPU and GPU cards with a large cooling solution. So we might be looking at what is in Navi 10 Lite APU. Or what has been leaked to be the Gonzalo APUs. I guess we'll have to wait until the Xbox Scarlet, PS5, or Big Navi comes out for us to see exactly what this ray tracing tech is. Moving on, but sticking to GPUs, the RTX 2070 Super has been spotted in a Final Fantasy XV benchmark. Yes, I know Final Fantasy XV is a pretty trash benchmark, and it's also an Nvidia optimized one, but it's worth taking a look. The 2070 Super has a score of 7,479 points at 1440p, which is an 11.9% increase over the regular RTX 2070. As we discussed previously on this channel, the RTX 2070 Super is supposed to have 256 more CUDA cores compared to the vanilla version, which equates to, drumroll please, 11.1% more CUDA cores, so more CUDA cores, more power. Now the RX 5700 XT is far behind at 5575 points, but once again, it's an Nvidia optimized benchmark, so it's not really worth comparing the two. I mean, look at the Radeon 7 for example, it's getting matched by a 1660 Ti. That's pretty sad. Anyways, take this for what you want, but it looks like Nvidia's got some winners here. And by winners, I mean money winners, because they're expensive. Then we have some Intel GPU news with their Chinese division posting a render and giving us a little more information on the Xe GPUs. According to the post on Weibo, which is like a sort of Chinese Twitter, the company said that the first consumer cards will be based on their 10 nanometer process and released in 2020. Now we already knew that, but what we didn't know is that Intel has no plans to support ray tracing from the get-go. Ray tracing will only come to their second generation Xe consumer cards coming in 2021, so only 1 year later. Plus, we're gonna see the second generation on the 7-nanometer process. Intel staying on the same process for only 1 year before moving on? no 10 nanometer plus, 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 plus? Am I dreaming here? Anyways, with that information, the account, what the hell? With that information, the account also posted renders of the GPU. Because there were no credits on the photo, this led some outlets to believe that this is Intel's official design, but if you guys remember, that same GPU design appeared on the 2035 Intel Odyssey GPU Roundup. It was called the Gemini concept, and is supposed to use ion cooling. I'm sorry, but can we go back to the days of simpler GPU designs? I mean, I don't want to pay a premium for this. Well, I guess it's Intel, right? So they are premium. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for the news today. If you have any questions, you know where to put them. Don't forget to drop a like. It's always nice to see who enjoyed the video. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video right here to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. By the way, look at that. Look at that. I've got nothing on my desktop except for my Minecraft launcher. I don't know why I got super into it. Take care.